working to connect a region of over 600 bridges between our lands.
Aloy Tobunda from the New Era University ASEAN Studies Center and Center for International Linkages. For the first time in many years, the Philippines is suffering from a repeat of what happened in 1995, a potential rice crisis. And we are very honored to have with us this afternoon to help us shed light on this issue a very prominent agriculturist. He was formerly the Secretary of Agriculture, the Department of Agriculture, during the term of President Joseph Estrada. And he was formerly the head of ICRISAT. ICRISAT is an Indian-based organization, the International Crops Research Institute for Semi-Arid Tropics, which he converted from a struggling institute to one of the top performing centers of the Consultative Group on International Agricultural Research. Presently, he is connected as founder and chairman of the Inang Lupa movement that advocates and calls to action agriculture modernization and rural industrialization anchored on the four pillars of inclusiveness, science-based, resilient, and market-oriented development. We have no other than Secretary Dr. William Doliente Dar. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon po, Kaloy.
Okay, actually, suki kayo dito sa aming program.
Tama po, marami pong salamat.
You have guested in some of our programs already to shed light on different issues concerning the development of agriculture in the Philippines. Okay, potential rice crisis. Why is this happening again now?
Yeah, unang-una gusto kong pasalamatan po ang iyong programa at saka ikaw to have been invited to this very prestigious program to give my views, you know, being an agriculturist and having been in this sector of agriculture all my life as a profession. Having said that, let me trace back the events at bakit ngayon mayroon potential na rice crisis.
Hindi pa naman full-blown rice
Hindi
crisis.
Hindi pa po. Pwede pang agapan, I mean, pwede pang punuan, pero we are almost at the verge of the repeat of 1995. Una, you know, every country must have to contend kung ilan na ba yung kaya mo i-produce na in this particular commodity rice dito sa ating bansa. You know, you have to really understand what have happened the last 10 years, even earlier. So the historical perspective is necessary, number one. Now, whether or not itong leaders natin sa agriculture and or the industry have considered looking at the data for the last 5 years in terms of price adequacy level and or the imports that have been done earlier on. Number two to be highlighted is we almost have to have what I call proactive
actions
or analysis actions, yes, of the situation and decide early enough because alam mo, rice is a political commodity,
yes,
we have to admit. So, let's trace back the events. With those two important points to highlight, yung historical perspective mo, at saka itong timing mo sa pag-decision making, I would call this as informed decision making process. Now, when did they start only discussing importing rice? Ako, ang pananaw ko ay, let's produce whatever rice we can produce in this country.
This rice self-sufficiency
and continue
thing,
to build up programs and or activities that will ensure higher levels of productivity for the long term. Hindi lang short term yan. So having said that, kung mayroon kakulangan, there are gaps, there are, say, you know, with historical perspective, the gaps would have been, for the last 5 years, nasa level ng 5 to 10%.
Okay.
Ang dapat import based on the consumption requirements.
So which means we should be producing 90 to 95% of our own rice.
That's what we produce today. We are now producing ang latest actually is 95-96%
okay.
Nandyan na dito, being produced by
our farmers. Okay.
Which means na yung kakulungan, iplano mo na bago mag-start ng year, iplano mo na, mag-decide na ang kinakaukulan kung ilan, kailan. O ilan million metro tonelada
at kung kailan
para tingin itong mga imports okay. At kung saan mo i-position
okay.
Itong mga imports.
So what happened?
Discussions were made in the first quarter, walang decision. Kasi parang there were contentions na mayroon tayong sapat na production. I was telling them mayroon akong article sa Manila Times last November last year, sabi ko importing rice should not be considered a controversial
issue
because dapat of course alamin mo yung sinabi ko na kung i-consider mo lahat
the historical data.
Yes. So walang decision sa first quarter.
Okay.
Then second quarter nagpo-porsige sila na again, the administration NFA forwarded its request to the NFA Council for them to finally decide the levels of information. Mayo na, nabigyan, I think. That's, if I'm not mistaken, they decided in May.
To finally import.
Well,
they have been traditionally importing starting first quarter.
Yes, first quarter. Okay. At darating na sa lean months particularly. Yes. So ito yung this aggravated the situation. Mm-hmm. Yung sabi ko nga, yung decision na kung kailan na decisionan ito ay late.
Too late.
Mm-hmm. At yung inaangkat ay ngayon lang dumarating. At
during
the rainy season.
So, problema ngayon yan. So what
happened? How can you unload
so
much faster? Itong mga dumating tagulan.
You mean to say we don't have the facility to
infrastructure
to protect the unloading.
So anong nangyari doon sa mga na import? There are reports na may bukbuk na ito.
Yes,
so ang daming issues na talagang compounding issues.
So i-clarify lang natin, yung bukbuk, of course nung in-import yan walang bukbuk.
Siguro kasi well true pero if there are conditions that will lead to yung presence of bukbuk
na specifically ang tagal na naka-stop doon sa barko so mabubukbuk.
So now they have to fumigate that. So ang again we really have to really contain that this is every Filipino must have to ito ay parang it's a supreme requirement na ating gobyerno ay titingnan niya na dapat isang Pilipino all Filipinos must have affordable food
kasi there are reports that in some parts of Mindanao rice is criminally
yes.
I call it criminal kasi it's 70 to 80 pesos per kilo. My goodness, napakahirap.
Tama po.
Sometimes it's unbelievable. How can they allow? How can they have allowed this to happen?
Yes. So, siguro, Kaloy, let me add another point. You know, in importing rice. Kasi alam natin yung mga neighboring countries natin where we are importing rice from. Vietnam,
Thailand. Cambodia, yes.
We have to understand when is their harvest period.
Yes.
Bakit
yes.
Kamo? Because these are the times that you can get it
at a lower
at
price.
Lower prices.
Kasi mas maraming stock.
Opo, okay. Ganun po. Mm-mm. Ang Vietnam have 3 croppings a year.
Wow.
So, yun, dapat na alam natin lahat. At talking at productivity levels, it brings you kung 3 croppings a year, ang productivity level per hectare per year ang Vietnam ay nasa 20.5 metric tons. Anong productivity level ng Pilipinas with 2 croppings a year? Nasa 9.5.
So talagang talon-talon
tayo. Talon-talo.
So which means even our quest for self-sufficiency talagang medyo...
It's a long way yet. Okay. I can discuss that if we have time.
Yes.
What must be done. Kasi talagang... Well, in brief, I can now early...
Actually, we will discuss that.
About, okay, thanks.
We'll discuss about that later when Asian in Focus returns.
Events happen around us all the time, in our community, in our country, around the world. Events that affect people, move communities, or simply inspire us. Interesting events that people need to know. In these interesting times, we continue to be a competent partner in delivering news about these events. Fast, accurate, balanced, Eagle News. Because we live in interesting times.
Saan mo pwede i-report yung possible violation of cybercrime prevention law?
Bakit puro yung mga guys ang nagpapakamatay, yung mga girls, parang wala na.
Kasi po bilang influencer, dapat hindi ka lang po talaga para sa sarili mo.
At naman yata ambisyon nila magkaroon ng online business.
Ano ba yung step ni ko? Bakit ba yung step mo?
Okay, balik tayo sa ating panayam kay Dr. William Dar. At we're still talking about the issue of the impending rice crisis in the Philippines. Actually, if you can't call it a rice crisis yet. Okay, earlier we were talking about the reasons why we're suffering from this now, a repeat of the 1995 situation. And before we ended, we talked about how are we faring in our rice productivity compared to our ASEAN neighbors.
So, maybe Kaloy, bigyan ko rin pansin yung development this year. Na ang budget ng NFA, binigyan ang national government ng 5.1 billion
okay.
to buy palay from local produce.
Okay, what happened?
What happened ay hindi nila po ginamit. And that exacerbated. Where did they use the money?
So it's not a matter of exporting rice, pero yung mismong buying rice from our local producers.
Yeah, that would have been a good move.
Hindi
na buying from our farmers, yung local produce, they were given
5.1 billion. So what happened?
Ang ginawa po nila, as per reports, ay pinambayad ng utang nila. Of course, ang claim nila ay...
Sumakit ang ulo ko doon. Sige po.
Ang claims nila ay para mas marami silang magamit sa pambili ng bigas. Pero... Kung ano yung nandun sa batas, sinabi nga niya, bibili ka sa local
sa
produce.
Local,
so there is some sort of technical malversation that's happening there. Yun. So another thing to point out ay, ang NFA has been mandated or may mandato na mag-imbak ng 15 days to 30 days
na buffer stock.
Buffer stocking.
Okay. All over the archipelago yan.
So meaning, kung may kalamidad, mayroon siyang ilalabas, o sa mga maliliit, mga poorest of the poor, mayroon silang, may pullback tayo.
So,
and this is one way to stabilize the prices.
Yes, yes. So what happened?
This is the, if I can remember, this is the first time in history na little by little, yung buffer stock ng NFA ay mataas hanggat nawala. So which means pag wala ka ng
buffer stock low supply
of course,
and demand.
Low supply, how can you
that explains the 70 to 80 pesos
ngayon
price
na ang presyo ng bigas.
My
goodness. You know? So meron tayong datos diyan na ang taas po ng January ang NFA buffer stock ay nasa 107,000 metric tons.
Metric tons, oo.
By June, naging 2.1. So, how can you now stabilize prices in the market? So, habang bumababa po yung buffer stock capacity ng NFA, anong ginawa ng commercial traders? They hoarded. They withheld the release of more commercial rice in the market, taking advantage of the situation, jacking up rice prices. So it's really
and you can't blame the rice traders because
it's
business. The NFA is there to really, you know, to stabilize. We don't want to point fingers, of course.
Now, going back now to your
nangyari. Okay.
To your
question,
can we compete?
Yes. Can we compete with our neighbors?
The neighboring countries like Vietnam and Thailand. Ito po mga datos. Vietnam has 7.5 million hectares devoted sa rice production. At nasabi ko na kanina na 3 croppings a year. So, sufficiente sila with their population of only 95.5 million.
The Mekong River.
And free, the natural resource,
which
is water, is, 100% irrigation. So, and the yield per unit area, per hectare ay mataas, nasa level na ng 6 metric tons, almost. So, yun ang factor.
That's Vietnam, oh.
Yeah, Vietnam. Thailand, ay mayroon siyang level na 11 million hectares.
So, mas malaki pa kasi
malaki.
Sa Vietnam.
Ang population nila ay 60 million. And, of course, yung production per unit area nila is mas mababa kaysa sa atin, sa Pilipinas. Although, yung cropping intensity nila, because of Mekong Delta, mas mataas, 3 croppings.
So they're endowed with all of this natural
resources. Yes, endowed in natural resources, even in hectarages.
They have a smaller population also.
Now, going back to say, what's the cost of producing a kilo of palay? Okay, Vietnam is 650 pesos.
Per kilo
of palay. Thailand is 850.
Oh, mas mataas.
Mas mataas. Sa atin, ilan? 1250. So how can you compete now, presently, with that high level of, you know, cost of producing a kilo
of palay? Which means it's malabas, it's cheaper to import.
Well, that's true, it's cheaper to import, but let's not emphasize that part, but emphasize on a long-term plan of government to make rice farming a very productive and competitive
Is that
industry.
Possible given this
well, dapat you said? Mayroon tayong, as I've said, mayroon tayong strategies to make it possible na productive tayo, na resilient tayo, na competitive tayo. Mayroon ba? Yan ang katanungan.
Filipinos are not known to be strategic thinkers.
And much plans. More doing implementation.
So is there hope? Sa tingin ninyo, may pag-asa ba?
May pag-asa. Ang dami pong, you know, let me cite a number of areas where we need to improve. Number one is, you know, irrigation systems development. Today, meron pa rin tayong potential na magawa ng irrigation, 1.3 million hectares.
Okay.
So that, we, you know, patubig ay talagang yun ang isang major factor.
Provided that they do not convert this land to, you know,
that's
to
one issue.
Non-agricultural
let's
uses.
Protect our productive agricultural lands into conversion for other uses. So now, going back to irrigation systems development, you need if you really have to aspire for self-sufficiency in rice, you accelerate the construction of more irrigation systems. Ano ang data natin? Ang administration, of course, last administration, they only targeted almost 200,000 hectares. Ito ngayon, 400,000 hectares. So may naiwan pa na 900,000 hectares pwede pang padubigan.
Are these new irrigation projects? Or
these are new.
Okay, so this is apart from those being repaired.
Correct.
Okay.
Doon sa existing systems natin, we have total of 1.5 million hectares.
Okay.
Pero ang efficiency niyan during dry season ay almost kalahati lang.
Which yung means talagang,
may patubig.
So talagang hanggang 2 cropping seasons lang
ang maximum natin. Yeah, 2 cropping seasons.
Okay, so irrigation, apart from irrigation.
Number 2, mechanization. Ano ang level ng mechanization natin sa Pilipinas kumpara sa ibang bansa? 2.2 horsepower per hectare.
Compared to
Vietnam, nasa 5 to 6 horsepower na. So, we have to enhance, okay? If we have really, kasi that's one way to reduce significantly yung cost of producing,
cost of production, yes.
Yeah, per kilo palay. It will handle about 4 pesos already. Of course, masasabi natin na maraming displacement of labor. Yes, totoo yun. Yes. But you need to have a long-term plan to how to tap this displaced labor, transforming them, retooling them into skilled labor. Again, okay. For rural industries.
Okay, how about the other inputs? So we have irrigation, we have mechanization.
Technology. Like yung paggamit ng hybrid rice or high-yielding varieties ng rice.
Actually, so, isang issue to, no, Secretary, no? Iri is here.
Opo.
And I was once given a tour of Iri and you saw all of these technologies. Bakit hindi yan ginagamit sa
hindi
Pilipinas?
Hindi natin ginagamit.
Bakit?
I don't know. Again, maybe there's low investments given to the sector of agriculture, which is true. Yun ang isang problema natin. Hindi pa binibigyan ng higher level of priority in terms of investments from government.
Okay,
at kukunti rin yung involvement or investment ng pribadong sektor.
Tapos sinasabi natin our growth rate during the last quarter dipped down because of the very low percentage contributed by agricultural sector. Then
kasi
we should do something about agriculture.
Yeah, 0.6% ang growth itong last 6 months compared to previous year, nasa level ng 2.5.
Bakit ganun kaya? Actually, you were agriculture secretary before, but and of course, from the data we have, it was during your term that we had very the highest agricultural
and that has not been surpassed up until today.
Why is
okay,
our priorities like this?
I would like
why
to highlight like this? Two factors. Why we succeeded during that period. You know, pagkaupo pa namin, President Era was there leading the team. Sabi niya, let's have food summit with the LGUs. Kasi mayroon nang batas devolving extension, di ba? Agricultural delivery
actually,
services.
That's one problem recognized, the failure, the stopping of the agricultural extension services because DA was devolved.
Correct.
So dapat sa LGU mo idadaan na talaga.
Dapat dalawa.
Empower the LGUs, yes.
So yun, partnership ng DA, LGUs with state universities and colleges. Para magampanan natin yung mas mataas ng ani, mas mataas ng kita.
Anyway, so hindi nangyari yun? Okay.
Well, nangyari to some extent. There are good partnerships. But
hindi na-sustain
pala. Hindi po na-sustain over long time.
And hopefully, pag na-sustain yan sa mga pag we adapt that again, hindi na mangyayari itong mangyayari na potential rice crisis. And of course, we need to do something with the management of NFA or with NFA as
correct.
A whole.
At ang pang-apat, para kasi sila yung nasa front lines ng war it's war against hunger and poverty ang ating mga magsasaka may edad na 57 years old average
isang mahabang usapan
yan yes you need to retool you need to give them new skills
and you have to make agriculture more attractive
to the younger generation
para magpatuloy yung ating
yun po paano ba yon it's such a very you have the arsenal
okay maraming salamat sa inyong tayo sa oras but we will continue this interview catch the full interview with Dr. William Dar in Asian in Focus weekend edition and in the meantime
salamat
thank you
po.
Very much Dr. Dar maraming salamat thank you very much that's all folks I'm Color Tabunda and I'm one with 25